welcome to AV Plus. This is the new podcast from Commercial Integrator Magazine on all things AV and commercial technology. I'm Adam Forziati, the web editor for CI. Something that we sometimes talk about here at the magazine is mission-critical tech applications, and I'm sure you do too. There's been a topic on many people's minds right now in and outside of AV, given what's been happening across the country with gun violence, especially gun violence at schools. You may be able to do something about that, though, as tech installers, and that's a pretty, I don't want to say exciting thing, but it's a pretty inspiring thing. After the Parkland, Florida shooting last month, there was a discussion in the media about how to properly lock down a school in the event of an active shooter situation. Now, this coverage has shed light on one piece of technology that's designed to minimize the time it takes to notify law enforcement and to lock down a building, all by hitting a single button. IntraLogic Solutions came up with what they call a one-button lockdown in the wake of the 2012 shooting at Sandy Hook Elementary School. And it's a fine example of what in this day and age is one of the most mission-critical technology applications in existence. Let's hear IntraLogic CEO Lee Mandel.
So IntraLogic created the one-button lockdown system actually right after Sandy Hook. You know, we went and met with a lot of communities around the country, and they told us about the challenges they have in locking down and securing their buildings during an emergency situation such as a lockdown. And the more we spoke to parents, teachers, community members, and especially law enforcement, the more we realized how critical time is and seconds truly do matter in a situation like this. And the more we hear about it, the more we speak, the more we understand that seconds matter, seconds will save lives. So we really analyze what they do during a lockdown. And different states and different locations around the country do different things, but the general fundamentals are all the same. You know, we have to lock the doors exterior to avoid people from coming in. We have to let people from the outside know not to come in. We have to let the community know so they don't descend upon the building. We have to let the students know, the staff know. So there's a lot of different components. And when we looked at schools and what they do from a manual process, you know, we could be talking 5 to 15 minutes to successfully achieve all these. So what I always say is you don't want to have to pull out the checklist and say, what do you do first, second, and third? The other component that we realize is how difficult it is to determine who's going to have the permission and the ability to perform this lockdown. Again, you're putting this very important decision in people's hands, but you don't want to be limited to who has that capability. God forbid, as we've seen in some of these situations, they go to the main office and take out the principal or the main office staff. Well, if they're the only people who can call a lockdown, now we don't have anyone else who can call that lockdown. And if there's shots being fired in the building. So what we did is we created the one-button lockdown, which has multiple initiation devices and multiple enunciation devices. So from an initiation standpoint, we have blue buttons that we typically mount in the main office, principal's office, and the greeter's desks. We have a mobile app that anyone from a cell phone could lock or lock down a building or lock out a building. We then have the ability from any computer keyboard within the building to hit a hotkey, type in a PIN code, lock the building down. Any phone within the building can call a lockdown by hitting a hotkey on the IP phone system, as well as wireless pendants, including our software. So again, multiple ways. You never know where you're going to be, and now you're not limited. When we hit the lockdown, we immediately do several things. We call the police directly, but we have a direct E911 solution that ties directly to the computer-aided dispatch of law enforcement. We then lock the exterior doors so no one's cards will allow them to get in. We flash strobe lights outside the building so that people know not to come back to the building. We send out text messages to parents, teachers, and students so they know we're in a lockdown situation. We automatically lock interior classroom doors, make a pre-recorded announcement over the PA system in the principal's voice with a lockdown siren tone as well, and we also take over the computer screens in the building. Some new features we've also worked out is we now take over the website of the school district to show an emergency notification on the website, as well as digital signage throughout the campus. So we take all these manual processes and we automate them into one singular process to really speed up the response time tremendously.
It's one thing for an integrator to understand their clients. If their clients simply want a video wall or video conferencing system, that can accommodate like a bring-your-own-device kind of setup. But school safety is inherently more complex than that, as you no doubt gathered from Lee's explanation of how the one-button lockdown system works. So who did IntraLogic consult with to ensure their solution was comprehensive enough to save lives if need be?
Well, the nice thing about the one-button lockdown solution is it's a modular process. We spoke to security experts around the country, and we said, what do you do during a lockdown? What's your biggest challenge? Where are some of the weaknesses? How can we speed the process up? It always comes down to that seconds matters concept, and that's what we've really prided ourselves in doing. We've actually been licensing it. We've built our dealer network about 3 years ago, and it's been expanding rapidly. We have about 100 dealers around the country. The system's right now in over 2,500 buildings around the country. So we have been accepting dealerships. Specialized training is involved. We don't want to just pass this out to any mom-and-pop company because it does integrate with several systems, but it's a very unique technology, and it is something that we are licensing around the country for use in educational establishments, higher ed, as well as commercial environments as well. We're always a software developer. Anytime we see a challenge in the market, you know, we have our technology company that creates these different components. Although a big part of our business in the New York metro area is integration, around the rest of the country, we're a software developer. We're a manufacturer of technology, and we work with local integrators around the country to provide them a seamless solution to really enhance the safety and security of these establishments.
So thank you very much for listening to AV Plus, and be sure to listen to our last episode if you haven't already. It's our longer monthly show featuring a debate between our own Craig McCormick and several AV tweets. We release shorter weekly shows like this one every Friday. You can find us on Twitter with the hashtag AVPLUSPod and online at commercialintegrator.com. Thanks for listening.